訳わかりにくい、迷ってしまう、画面酔いを起こす、3D のゲームを作るのは必ず登場するキーワードですね。
Depth misperception, getting lost, motion sickness. These are the key phrases we worry about the most when creating a game in a three-dimensional world.
私たちはたくさんのオブジェクトと同時にどなたにでも楽しんでいただけるプレイ環境を提供したい。言うなればサプライズとイージープレイを目標に日々開発しています。
But we also focus on the positive, like creating a sense of surprise so the player can constantly be astonished by the world.We also try to make the games easy to play, so that we can create an environment where anyone can enjoy themselves.
ならこのようなプレイの快適さ、プレイの快適さを妨げる問題を限りなくゼロにしたいと思う。
And to do this, you have to completely eliminate all the problems that obstruct ease of play.
ではここでその戦いについてご紹介します。
Let me introduce to you the kinds of struggles we undertake to achieve this.There's an enemy in the Mario series known as the Goomba.
最初に登場する踏んで倒す典型的な敵なんですが、このクリボーが 3D ではなかなか踏めないということです。
This is the first enemy to appear, and it's of the typical stomp to the feet variety, but many people seem to have trouble landing on him in 3D.
テレビの画面の中の物体は立体的に作られたものですから、見た目は立体でも、メニューは平面なので、視差を利用することができません。
On a TV screen, objects do not have the same kind of physicality. We can make them resemble real objects, but the eye will still perceive them as being flat. There's no difference in the two eye views.
ですから、立体が距離感をつかみにくい。
That's what makes it difficult for people to grasp the physicality and depth of objects like that.
そこでマリオ64では少しでもそれを補助するために地面に感度を落とすことを徹底しました。
In order to address this issue somewhat, we decided to drop a shadow on the ground everywhere in Mario 64.
宙に浮いている物体から落ちてくるお金、これでマリオの下に落ちた丸いやつですけども、マリオやブロックの壁です。
That way, every floating object, whether it was jumping Mario or a block, would have a reference point on the ground. That's the small circular shadow you see directly beneath you there.
物体の落下点を要求するのはとても効果的で、3D のジャンプアクションではテストプって言ってほど重要な種類だと考えています。ポイントは光源の位置に関わらず必ず真下に落とすことです。
The distance between an object and its shadow on the ground below is so effective at expressing height.That we've almost come to think of it as an ironclad necessity for 3D platformers. For this feature to work, the shadow has to fall directly beneath the character, regardless of the light source's position.
正直に光源から影を落としてしまうと、リアリティは失われるんですけどね、下の方の影は見やすいです。
If you place the shadow where it would normally fall based on the light source position, the player will lose the reference point for where they are going to land. This may not be realistic, but it is much easier to play with the shadow below. With Super Mario Sunshine, we implemented a new kind of hover. No.
曖昧な距離感を時間の移動を作ってイージーにすることがあります。重力のちっちゃなジャンプですね。
We made it so the player could shoot water down to make Mario hover in the air during the jump. Giving the player more time in the air to resolve any ambiguity in the appearance of distance was a step towards creating the ease of play we hoped to achieve. It's basically a low gravity jump.
これらのどうしても高さや奥行きの問題を全て解消することはとても難しいです。スクロールのマリオの時代ではありえなかったんですね。
But even with these new ideas, resolving the problem of height and depth misperception proved to be quite hard. This was a kind of frustration that we couldn't have imagined in the days of working on 2D Mario scrolling platformers.
そこでこう考えることにしました。
Suddenly, we had a thought.
マリオだからといって、ジャンプして踏むという規制概念で決めるではなくて、アナログスティックを動かして、
Just because Mario has always jumped and stomped on his enemies doesn't mean he always has to. We try to think of gameplay involving running around using the control stick. That would be fun.
3D なら 3D にできたマリオの遊びを考えていくというわけです。
We thought about how to adapt Mario's style gameplay to the concept of 3D.
後ろに回り込んでくるくる回して放り投げる。2D のマリオではなかったアクションですよね。
Sneaking around behind and grabbing Bowser's tail so you can spin and throw him. This is an action you would never be able to do in a 2D Mario game.
マリオサンシャインでは水を当てるという元とは違ったアクションを作りました。放水という方法で奥行きを意識せずひたすら当てる遊びにしたんです。
In Super Mario Sunshine, we made another departure from the focus on stomping by allowing Mario to spray an enemy with water. Spraying water was an action that players could enjoy without worrying about analyzing depth and distance too much.
3D のアクションであるゼルダの伝説、時のオカリナではこんな取り組みをしました。
In Legend of Zelda: Ocarina of Time, another 3D action game, we tried this kind of approach.
ゼルダではご覧のようにプレイヤーリンクが剣で敵を切ったり、敵の攻撃を避けたりしなきゃいけません。
In a Zelda game, as you can see, the player must be able to strike enemies with his sword and avoid their attacks.
このままでは距離や方向が定まらなくてなかなか剣が当たりません。
It's hard to use a sword, however, to determine the distance and direction of the enemy.
そこでボタンを押すと敵とプレイヤーの同じ軸上に進まれて、両者の距離も分かりやすい位置にカメラが移動するものを作りました。
We devised a plan for the motion of the camera that would treat the player and their target.As if they were on a single axis, and thus made it much easier to determine the distance between them.
こうやって敵の方を突っ切りながら移動して攻撃や防御をします。これによって戦っている時の距離感の不足や軸ずれの不安をちょっとだけ解消できたかと思います。
This way, the player can keep an eye on the enemy while moving, attacking, or defending. I think this helps to reduce the frustration.That came from losing line of sight on the enemy and some of the difficulty in perceiving distance to the enemy as well.